72,000-strong Wembley crowd left no one in doubt that this was one of rock's most charismatic performers.
This is made for Freddie. You know, hello, the planet. Huge, man. How many bands played that thing? Everybody. Queen smoked them. They just took everybody. I don't wanna die. Sometimes wish I'd never been alone. The last people anyone expected to come out of that gig as being the memorable ones were Queen. We have an ear to use our ears. I do remember looking up and seeing every single hand or arm in Wembley. Got exactly how many and who was watching this and just thrived on it.
Seen Queen a couple of times, but I didn't expect this incredibly finely honed performance. Are we here? Radio Gaga. Radio Boo-Boo. Radio Gaga. Are we here? Is Radio Gaga. Radio Gaga. Radio.
The replay, and it sends shivers down your spine.
I remember getting a bit of a lump at the time, thinking, my God, this is not a Queen audience, but this is happening. It was an incredibly charged moment.
It soon became clear to everyone that this was a band delivering the world's greatest set at the world's greatest gig.
Everyone had been amazing, but this seemed to me to be of another order.
How many thousand people all clapping at once like the Nuremberg rallies with a band at it? Radio Gaga, all we hear is Radio Gaga, Radio Boo-Boo,
Radio Gaga, all we hear is Radio Gaga. Freddie knew exactly how to get across to a stadium audience. The guy right at the back of Wembley Stadium still felt that Freddie had a connection.
You know how hard it is to get someone's attention who's on the other side of the room? Imagine a stadium, and imagine making them sing along with you. It's all for a famous
fire to through the backstage area, of all the stars, you have the unspoken feeling they're doing it. They're stealing the show.